All right, I guess I'll deal with with expletism, I'll call it. What is the rush? What is the rush going on right now? This rush for the well, first of all, there's the rush for the nuclear conclusions, that we fix it. We fix nuclear conclusions right now. Just get it over with and we fix it. And yet, I want to fight. I want to fight out here. I want to say there are the three places I've put there in choice. I've given Algeria, Middle Canada, and the outer realms of China, and I want to fight it. I want to fight those places, and we don't even have time to fight these places. We just have to put them there. It's become this direation. But that's not what I want to talk about. I'm speaking specific of the rush to the fanaticism of the events, because it is an absolute expletive and a famic moment. Fame, and it's not a fame. And more, it's an anxiety. It's an anxiety entration to even enter into the issues of it, the truth of it, because it is so disresolvable at the moment. The 250 hot... Oh, so I wrote this thing on. 250 hot... fuels, the tons, 250 tons of this, and that are currently in this one particular reactor that they can't cool, and so they have to somehow remove them and cool each one off, and dispose of it properly, and so yeah, that's what we're looking at. And if it's not done, then there's 140 million persons of Japan immediately at a major risk. And so this is the melt of continuance. And aside from that melt of continuance, we're talking the continual dumping into the ocean, and some ridiculous, now we got to go back to conspiracy theory, it's into the Bible. The Bible has stated and quoted it, 1/3 of the seas will die off, the oceans will die. That is a Bible prophecy. Well, that could very easily have been some kind of a hack job, and I will say a hack job. Somebody could have easily provoked the earthquake into the make. We already know this. Just to realize the good book on somebody's platter or somebody's plate. See, I told you so. So there is all of this stupid rush with conspiracy theory also. And then, yes, there's the justification that they are going to get their loans wiped out and get to collect at a higher bounty off the property owners. So at this risk of this 140 million, the risk right now I'm seeing is we're talking evacuation, we're talking all these, get them out of there and how. I personally... I'm fanatic into immediately separate the tourists. Any persons that are there that are not normally Japanese, get them out of there on specific airplanes. Do not mingle them on the same planes any longer, because it takes time and evacuation. Just get the strangers immediately on those airplanes. And those particular non-residents, take them to a halfway area, and I said Australia, but Australia may be very upset with it, but take them there before if any further planes elsewhere to their ticket, to their original ticket location. That would have been my evacuation plan immediately. When those things start cranking out, like, under control. So, and then they're only dealing with the Japanese. They're only dealing with their persons there, standing there in the line. And they want to get out, you know. So, only dealing with them and moving them to China specifically, because China has the space. If they have to all move closer to those outer realms, then they have to move closer to those outer realms also. But yeah, we still need to keep these buffer zones free of disposable sites. What was I really speaking of, though? But it is the fanaticism of the event that I'm getting into, and it's an expletism that is rising and rising and rising, and I'm like, well, everything is wrong, everything is rushed, you know, I'm painting with a hot Mary Kay pink, and I don't even like the color, and this type of event, I'm rushing, and I'm a busy, you understand, I'm a rush, and I'm a busy, from even knowing about the spent evacuation of that filth water, radioactive, into the oceans. Because it is not stopping, and it's not going to stop. It's just hyped up. It's hyped up. So you can cool it and try to cool it and try to cool it. It's not going to be tomorrow it's cooled, is it? It's just going to be a continual. These suckers are just unbelievable that they even were invented. Now I have to think about the zoos. I have to think about the zoo protocol. You know, I have to think of these things immediately. The zoo, where are the healthiest polar bears? Where are the healthiest Kodiaks? Where are the healthiest moose? Where are all of these healthiest fertile animals? And keep some kind of a gene data bank of them in case we lose them all. All of these have to be materialized, all of these events. So we're also dealing with the fish of the oceans also. Major fish of the oceans, or the small little tinies, is much of it, everything we can get, even planktons in rare locations, if they have access to those. We have to keep all of these little items somehow, and they have to be kept in different areas of the planet because they have so many of these nuclear time bombs going off at any moment. So yeah, it puts me in expletism. Puts me in expletism. The news of the event has put me so freaking hyped that I don't even know about the title of this last painting. Actually, it wasn't the last. It was the one before the last, you know. And in expletism, I am in deep in true. I have to completely be truthful, you know, in complete interrogation state, because this is it, you know. This is it. We don't have time for lies. You know what I'm saying? There's no time for lies. So when we're moving huge amounts of persons, say, take the whole western coast of the United States, Canada, and even Mexico, when we're moving them from their west coast regions to the eastern coast regions of that particular continental zone, it's just going to have to expect influx of a huge amount of persons. That would be normal, and that is actually a safe resolve, unless the choice is by the dictum political to let the persons all die of quickened deaths into radioactive that type of thing, you know, all of those it's just not the rewind into higher rates of. It's not the rewind into that show. At this point in time, all cookies are pointing to it. All cookies. You know, it's just a sick. You know, you had the Three Mile Island. You had the Love Canal, whatever, leakage into that situation. You had way over there into the Chernobyl. Then you had now this other Fukushima. So now I'm thinking designs for these rods, getting them out of there and getting them into cool tanks. Why I have to be thinking these things, you know? Why isn't it already known? The Exodus situation, if it gets too hot, this is the answer. You know, so where is this resolve? How does it even make? How does this particular design or any of these designs even get made if they do not have an instant resolve if it gets too hot? If it gets too hot, what is the answer? It's not obliterate 140 million persons. Slow or fast. And ruin the oceans on the side. I have everything in my mind right now. I want even beep pingers, you know. I want loud radio, actual underground, underwater radios, to deter any migrating whales, any migrating fish schools, any type of fish that wants to go back into the oceans, Pacific. I want to put headers out there that are loud and aggressive and say, don't come this way. But in this action, what if there are some trying to flee and escape through? You know, they may be changing their domesticality of life on that ocean. So we can't really put loud music underwater, can we? We can't put music walls to stop them, because they're then the ones exiting. I mean, it's like they're being fried underneath there. It's like they're being electrocuted. I can't, you know, what is this? Is this expletism? Yes. Is it my fault? Is it my fault, all of this nuclear grug? I can blame it for sure on my father for giving me a hideous gosh dang beginning. I can blame him because he created a hatred in me. And I can blame other fathers for creating hatreds in their daughters. Needing more energy, needing more houses, larger, further away. Creating suburbia way, way, way far away from those fathers. Get away from them. Get away from the mothers, even. The sons have to get away from their mothers. So you blame it. You can go back to the birth, all of our births and our raising and our childhoods and our resentments, yes. And it did create extra, a nuclear need overload. So anyway, yeah, darn, I'm entering into these gosh dang headlines of Fukushima expletism. And I really need to realize I do have a tangle with yes, we go back to the water lilies. The water lilies clean the water. The water lilies do survive because they pop out first. They're the ones that do survive from these radioactive fallout events quicker. They have a rejuvenance. So using them as a filter for the water is an idea, obvious. Using them also in conjunction with an oxygen, with a filter for the oxygen intake through, is also a... So I'm stuck on looking at Lake Chapala at the moment with the tangle strangle of water lilies. I'm thinking of this type of problem and how that problem could actually possibly be a filter for the water from underneath. Perhaps there is a water from underneath. I haven't figured it out. I can't make this drawing right now. Look at this, and I've changed my setting here. I'm so freaking angry. I can't believe. Yeah, so the hurry up and then make that zoo forum, everyone, with the, yeah, I got the polar bears here that are really, really never been in one, never been in a fallout zone. Yeah, I got the special animals over there that have never been in a fallout zone. I don't know. Is this all it is? You know, this is just constructionism again and again and again. Point back to the Bible book and go, see, everybody, we told you so. Is this all it is, a constructionism? Or which one really did happen first? Chicken or the egg, you know? Blame it on the earthquake, or was it really the meltdown first, you know? You have all kinds of theories that can just start beginning. Was it actually the meltdown that caused the earthquake? Then thusly the tsunami. Or was it a simple missile drop into the ocean, into the crack of the fault lines, because they already know where those are. just dropping some kind of a missile from a submarine. If it was nuclear, they would have perhaps seen it or spotted it, but if it was other type, maybe not. Maybe they could have hidden it. I don't know. There's a lot of persons that just want population overload to go away. They have money, territorial domination problems. You know, it's just become a world a little too topsy-turvy with personas of trying to gain their power over others. So I don't know if this video makes any sense to anyone, but I just don't have the answer. I don't have the answer for Lily, water lilies, cleaning the oxygen. But that would be a room that was already given some kind of filtration through some kind of a charcoal, some kind of a sand, some kind of a straw, because it has to be an organic situation for survival. It has to be an organic situation. It's not going to be anything industry supplied. It has to be something that is an organic situation. I don't know. I don't know. I don't like the title of this last painting. It's just too wrong. And yeah, I'm not finished, like I said, of throwing Mary Kay pink at it. Is that a funny ending?